Good evening to everyone who is watching Toyota Times Athletes Now. I am Morita Kyonosuke, your main anchor. I'm Kozuka Takahiko, your athlete presenter. It is August now, and it's day 10 of the Olympic Games Tokyo 2020 and of this program. How exciting! Now, this program gives its full support to the 234 global team Toyota athletes from 47 countries and regions. There are 127 DTTAs participating in the Olympics. Let's continue to cheer on. You know, every time we give you this program, we've been able to talk about how wonderful our athletes are competing. And Emma Twigg actually sent us this message. Take a look.
To the Toyota family, thank you so much for your support. I'm Emma Twigg from New Zealand, gold medalist in the women's single scull. Your support has been amazing. Much appreciated. Arigato.
How wonderful it was to hear from Emma. She said thank you very much for all the support. Appreciate that coming from Toyota family. And she really was appreciative. She even closed with a Japanese word of thank you. And of course, when we speak of the success of GTTAs, I have to mention this. A couple of days ago in this program, I was saying that Caleb Dressel may win as many as 4 medals, but look, this is the result. 5 medals. Wonderful. Freestyle, 50 meters, and also 4x 100 meter freestyle relay. He won 2 additional gold medals, so altogether, with world record on the way, he has acquired 5 gold medals. This is Tokyo Olympics or Dressel Olympics, you might say that in some sense. Yep. This is it though, right? Yeah, he finished his competition. And he's becoming quite a famous face as a GTTA. I hear people recognizing him. And of course, make sure that you send your SNS messages to these athletes with hashtag Toyota Times Live. It will certainly reach out to them. And we are looking forward to your comments during the webcast as well as YouTube and Instagram. And this is brought to you live from 7 p.m. with simultaneous interpretation available in English. And it's archived, so make use of your spare time, please, to check it out. Oh, we've got some comments already. One comes in from Singapore. Now, today is Welcome to Tokyo from Around the World, Part 3, North America, as a featured story. There are many. Here we go. Okay, so let me bring you the results of competition. Yesterday and so far today. Of course, GTTAs and the country and regions that they represent are in red. Of course, Weiss Eidinger of Australia won the bronze medal. Congrats, congrats. This is the first medal brought to Australia in this sport. And of course, Adams in shot put had won bronze medal representing New Zealand. This is actually the 4th consecutive medal in the Olympics. That's after Rio. And next is 3,000 meter steeplechase. Klaus goes on to the next stage with 5th qualified representing Germany. And also Norman, USA, 14th qualified. Now, volleyball, Araki, Tashiro, Kura had played, but they have lost against Korea. But they have a match coming up versus Dominica. They could actually move on if they win at that time. And here Italy has won against Venezuela. Zaitsev did very well. That's a straight victory. And Zaitsev actually is sending out messages on the SNS, so please check that out. And also tonight, Japan is going to compete against Iran. This is going to be a very important match for Japan, so let's cheer for them. And also fencing, Sabre team, Banners France has won the silver medal, congrats. Next is football, Japan. Of course, we have Soma on that team. After the PK against New Zealand, they have moved on to semi-final. They're going to fight against Spain. Now, handball, men's first league. On Japan team, there are eight GTTA. Iwashita Sakai played very well. Versus Portugal, this is the first victory in 33 years. They're going to withdraw after this first league, but it was nice to see their victory. And of course, in Vaut, Moreno has done the fourth placing. And then also Lee, Pamel Horse, that was the first passing. And when it comes to wrestling, Weave representing Canada. She was a Rio gold medalist, but she has lost here. And in basketball, Japan's first league, it was a final match there. Japan has lost and has three consecutive losses. But it was the first appearance in 45 years. Baba Watanabe, Tanaka Schaefer, all of them played very well. Thank you. And golf, Matsuyama's final day was a 15 under. It was a third tie, but after playoff, he didn't catch the medal. And then sailing, Okada is performing better, race 7 fifth, race 8 fourth. And of course, Lange and Clansa, representing Argentina, is now cumulative ranking of the seventh. They're going to go on to the final race. So it's so wonderful to see them.
Today's special feature. It is Welcome from the World to Tokyo, Part 3, North America. Yesterday, we had part two, Oceania, so today is about North America. Outside of Japan, the most number of GTTA are from the United States, 18 members. There are many GTTA from North America in Tokyo 2020, including the United States, Canada, Mexico, and Puerto Rico. Adriana Diaz from Puerto Rico was featured in our first Welcome from the World to Tokyo. Thanks to her, table tennis became popular. It's a popular sport in Puerto Rico, right? Yes, with one prominent player on a global stage will shed light to a sport. And by more and more people playing, athletes will become stronger. It is a virtuous cycle. She plays an important role. This time, she finished 17th, but on Instagram, she posted, "I will continue effort until glory will be brought to Puerto Rico." Let's continue to support her. Now, let's go to Mexico. There are two GTTA in Tokyo now from Mexico. Aida Roman in archery is a silver medalist in London 2012, who brought the first medal to Mexican archery. This time's result. After that, she posted on Instagram. She said, "I had great experience competing in a difficult wind condition." Her results weren't her best, but she will prepare for her next competition. A forward-looking comment from her. Let's continue to support her too. And also from Mexico, Alexa Moreno in artistic gymnastics. She started training from 3 years old with advice from her mother. However, the training environment was harsh. No air conditioner and temperature sometimes up to 50 degrees Celsius or 122 degrees Fahrenheit. First Mexican medalist in women's artistic gymnastics. Her strength. Personally, my strength lies in the vault. I think I am very explosive and powerful, and I think that's my biggest strength, and I want everyone to watch out for. Yes. So she was eighth in vault women's qualification. In today's final, very close, but she's placed in fourth. But as she said in the interview, she's really, really powerful. From her run, she's really, really powerful, and her jump too, and a beautiful, beautiful stand that she showed. Actually, Moreno, she loves K-pop and Japanese anime, Asian culture. In floor exercise qualification, she chose a song from Demon Slayer Kimetsu no Yaiba. Maybe some of you noticed. Yes. And next, Canada. There are three JTTA members from Canada in Olympic Games Tokyo 2020. Ellie Black in artistic gymnastics, Melissa Bishop in athletics, and Erica Weeb in wrestling. Black had to withdraw from the all-round competition final due to her injury, but we heard she will come back from balance beam on August 3rd. Bishop competed in athletics 800-meter heat, however, couldn't qualify. That was day before yesterday. On Instagram, she posted, "I cried a lot, but I feel proud of myself. I was able to come back as a mother thanks to my team and sponsor. Thank you for all your support." Yes, that was her post. She said as a mother, she was saying she wants to show her daughter her effort and inspire women that we can do it even when we're mothers. I'm sure her run in Olympic inspired people around the world. Yes, thank you very much. And Weeb, as mentioned, wrestling today, women's 76 kilogram, her first match she lost, it was a sad surprise. Yeah, Rio gold medalist losing. However, yeah, this is the world-class competition, so I hope she will continue on for her next competition.
So, welcome to Tokyo from around the world, part 3. North America at last, United States of America. 8 GTTAs are here in Tokyo from the United States of America. The first athlete who comes to my mind when I say representing the USA is a softball player, Abbott. Now, also, Kelsey Robinson, the U.S. Women's volleyball player who joined Toyota Auto Body last month, that's joined GTTA. Yeah, this right bottom, Kelsey. Abbott and Robinson are based here in Japan, but many of the U.S. Athletes are supported by TMNA, Toyota Motor North America. So I asked Mr. Jack Hollis, Senior Vice President of TMNA, what it is doing to support these athletes.
Number one, most important, is that we as a company are here to support, to advocate, to encourage others. It's about what we can give to society versus what we can get. And I think what we've done really, really well in TMNA is take this entire movement of Olympics and Paralympics and put our purpose is to give, support, and give to others. I also want to add, though, that it's about making a personal, emotional connection. And we need to understand that it's the emotional connection with each athlete and with all of our guests who are part of the Toyota family that will allow us to give more. And in that, we're able to give what I call cheers and tears of joy. Cheers and tears of joy. So we can help them to cheer and win. But there's also that emotional connection of tears, the tears of joy, the tears that we are, that's our purposes. And that's what we're striving for here in TMNA.
Wow. Cheers and tears of joy. So it makes sense for us to continue to give these words of encouragement, and we can all be united emotionally. You know, sports had started with the notion of hunting and the celebration of, you know, your hunted object together is at the root of sport, from what I have heard. So I think by Toyota family all together cheering, you know, as we are doing now, it really goes back to the roots, and it's give and take and a lot of giving, really, indeed, for that personal and emotional connection amongst us. We would like to do more. And there are several athletes who have already finished their competitions, Daryl Homer in fencing, and also Simone Manuel in swimming. Won a bronze medal in the women's 400-meter relay. And left bottom, Alice Willoughby didn't qualify, but she fought in the BMX racing, and she had Kaizen, continuous improvement on the side of her helmet. And of course, Dressel, he has won 5 gold medals. What an overwhelming, impressive result. Now, let's go to the athletes who are coming up. Well, Jordan Barrett, who will be competing in the new skateboarding event, Park. That's actually a complicated course from what we hear. So let's learn a little bit about this competition. Oh, like this. Jumping, and it's high jump. And from what I hear, the time is 45 seconds. So within 45 seconds, you know, they are to show high skill set that they have. Yeah, these are different techniques. It's very speedy. Wow. And how nice. Well, Barrett grew up in Hawaii, used to be a surfer, but when at the age of 11, skate park opened in the neighborhood and got hooked. So really versatile, both on land and on water, skateboarding and surfing. Sounds good. And Barrett has sent us this message. Take a look.
I guess just kind of got me excited for the Olympics and like everyone, and especially being a Team Toyota athlete, like it feels very like family based, and like that's really special to have, especially when I'm at the games, to have like like everybody there all together, like supporting you, cheering you on, from all sides of the company, including the athletes.
Wow, like a family. Just like a family. How wonderful to hear such words of hers. Now, Pullman, who we talked about at the beginning of the show, there's a comment saying thank you for the cheers. And also additional comments saying, so very nice to see you here in Tokyo. This additional message that I mentioned actually came from Barrett. So on this platform, they are connected, GTTA connecting and reaching out to another GTTA. Again, that kind of reminds me of the VTR comment that we received earlier, as we shared with you. Now, when it comes to Park, this skateboard prelims and finals are on Wednesday the 4th. Last but not the least, Michael Norman, who will be competing in the 400-meter athletics. His mother is Japanese and a former short-distance runner. He's ranked number 3 in the world and is a medal contender. Preliminary is held today. He did well, as we recapped, and he's going to go on to the semifinals.
Probably the most common thing people say or recognize me with is like patience, because I have it written all over my bio. But like, I'm not that patient, so if you write patience, I'll see that as a key word for me specifically. Yeah. Yeah, patient.
I see. Patience. So some of you cautious viewers may have noticed we have this writing in kanji character. It says patience in kanji character. Yeah, this is how we shall cheer for him, because he says you know, whenever he sees this word, he would notice that to be a message to him. You know, this is patience, just in case he needs translation. Yeah, let's cheer for him, like so. Yeah, patience. You know, some of you may have been inquisitive about the reason why we had this panel in the studio, but that's the reason. Now, you know, of course, TMNA's Senior Vice President Jack Hollis has more to comment.
I understand his feeling about being a father to these athletes, because I feel very similar, maybe sometimes like a father, sometimes like a brother. In fact, last night sitting here, I got to sit with many of the family members of athletes. Caleb Dressel is a U.S. swimmer. I got to sit with his mother last night and hugging and cheering, and there's that joy that comes with that. I think second is I have a personal relationship with all TMNA athletes. I know them personally. I have their cell phone numbers. I can call them. I interact with them. So I have a personal involvement with each of them. And I think because of that, it allows me to understand their journey, their, well, I don't know, concerns, but also their excitement. And so I share in that. So I share Akio's feeling of being in it. I will say a lot of times we use these words, one team, one family, one Toyota.
Yes. Well, he finished up nicely with a keyword. Of course, during the interview, Jack Hollis mentioned the names of so many GTTAs, and he told us about the points of interest one by one. You know, he has so much knowledge about the GTTAs, and I felt like he was really like a father. And a lot of the athletes are actually mentioning family words. So let's all do our best to support the GGTAs, our family around the world. You're going to keep that. Patience, you liked it. Yes. Yeah, this word patience. You know, we have a lot of feedback on SNS too on this. Yeah, Jack is a father, and then President Toyoda, of course, relates to that key message that Jack Hollis was talking about. Well, that's it for today's feature story. Welcome to Tokyo from around the world, Part 3, North America. Finally, schedules of GTTA tonight and tomorrow. Yes, tomorrow. So you can cheer on them. I am going to share the schedule with you. Tonight, athletics. 100-meter hurdle semifinal from Belgium. Zagre will be there. And depending on today's result, there will be the final tomorrow. Triple jump. Portugal, Mamona, there's a final. And 400-meter hurdles semifinal from France. Valian will be there. Next, beach volleyball men's. Norway, Molsoran pair. Round of 16, the first match will be against Netherlands. Hockey, men's quarterfinals from here will be a tournament match, and Charlier and Briels from Belgium will be against Spain. And from here will be tomorrow's schedule, athletics, men's 400 meters semifinal. Today's special feature, Norman will be there. With patience, please. And women, pole vault. Preliminary. Day before yesterday, we had a special feature of Stefanidi of Greece. She will be here. And table tennis, men's team. So tomorrow, there will be from the first match to the quarterfinal. The first match will be against Australia, Harimoto of Japan. Handball, Fujii from Japan. So it will be against Norway, the leader of the preliminary round. A win is a must. Volleyball, women. USA Robinson against Italy, and Araki Okumura Tashiro, Japan team, will be against Dominican Republic. Here too, a win is a must. Gambare. And artistic gymnastics. Samir Aid Said from France for the rings. He was third qualified and going into the finals. And Vanessa Ferrari from Italy, first qualified in the preliminary. Today,
this time, she was placed fourth and fourth in London and Rio for individuals. So aiming for a medal this time, let's support her. Beach volleyball, men's Wickler and Seoul pair from Germany versus USA. This is the first match in their finals. Canoe sprint is starting from the preliminary to the quarterfinals. Czech Fuchsa in Canadian pair and Lutz from Hungary in women's kayak single. And two more members from Hungary, Bodoni and Chipis. They will be in different pairs, but they will be in canoe sprint pairs. And basketball women's GGTA, we have six members had fought well against USA, one win, one loss. If they can win against Nigeria, there will be high hopes going to the next round. Six members of GGTA and shooting Penny from Hungary. He will be in three positions, which means kneeling and prone and standing. So three positions. It will be the preliminary to the finals. And sailing 470 Okada from Japan, 9th and 10th race. This will decide if he can go into the finals. Let's continue to support him. Cycling track. Kenny from UK, he will be the member of a team and team pursuit. In team pursuit, London Rio had gold, so aiming for the third time gold medal here. We have new sports coming in, and also there are members continuing their competition. We all need your support. Patience. Yes, let's post patience together. Yes, you don't need patience. You don't need to refrain yourself from supporting them. Let's support them all the time. The schedule and results of GTTA are on the special website of Toyota Times for Olympic and Paralympic. There will be interview videos and athlete SNS. We can see how they're doing, like Zaitsev of Italy. We see some buzzes on the SNS. Whenever you support them, don't forget the hashtag Toyota Times Live. Yes, let's spread the words. Yeah, and we can hashtag them, the names of the athletes too, right? Let's become one team through our support. Yes, today was our 10th day of Toyota Times Athletes Now. We have received lots of comments, right, Kozuka-san from YouTube, Taka Azuma-san. You are researching a lot about the athletes. Well, thank you. Yes, we have so many members. Out of 46 sports, we have 40 sports where GTTA is participating. So we are able to know a lot about new sports too. Yes, Samurai Hide said, it's really good that we can hear from Toyota leaders all around the world. Yeah, we see those interviews like Arello from Argentina and Jack today from USA. I think they're really, really precious interviews that we are receiving. Yesterday's interview too. Right? Australia, Matthew, and Akio Toyoda, our president, suddenly like a management meeting, right? Top management discussion. Of course about athletes, but we are able to know a lot about Toyota that maybe we don't really see in our everyday life. Yes, let's check out the archives too. Doremi 1208. Behind Kozuka-san, there's a skateboard. Yeah. Yes, USA skateboarding every day. Our staffs are deciding the layout. It's different every day. So you can comment me, Morita-san moved, and I think you will be able to see the background. And simultaneous interpretation, patience. Oh, they see lots of posts. Yes, patience. It's a really, really important keyword today, right? Let's support them through patience. Yes, those were the comments. Thank you very much. Tomorrow too? We will have Kozuka-san as our athlete presenter, and tomorrow's special feature is an island in the Caribbean Sea, Toyota Athletes of Martinique. Yes, from French territory Martinique, we will be focusing on the athlete Ludovic Vaillant, who was in 400-meter hurdle in athletics. And we have lots of support messages from the workplaces of Toyota and Naoto Inti Raymi support song. We are now very familiar to the song, right? So let's say a farewell with Naoto Inti Raymi's song. It was main anchor Morita Kyonosuke and athlete presenter Kozuka Takahiko. Thank you for watching Toyota Times Athletes Now. See you again tomorrow. One Toyota.